The Fermi paradox, aka our best guesses as to where the heck all the aliens are. Theory number one, home alone. Let's say this apple represents all intelligent life, and the table is the universe. Hypothesis one is that we human beings on planet Earth are the apple. We are the only intelligent ones out there. We are actually alone in the universe. This theory might be wrong, but it's a possibility nonetheless. Theory number two, fashionably late. A more likely theory is that we're not alone in the universe, but we're just late to the party. So some aliens, in this case these manas, came to our home planet before humans existed, but we weren't here to greet them. They left and are out there living their delicious lives, and we're just unaware of them. That would be really sad. Theory number three, the cool kids table. Another popular theory is that the aliens aren't just bananas. Instead, they're everything in this fruit basket. And they're all clustered at this end of the table having a fun fruit basket party with all the other delicious fruits in their vicinity. They're just so far away from where we're positioned in the universe that, from where we're sitting, we just think we're alone. In other words, aliens are out there. We just can't interact with them or tell they're out there because they're so far away. Theory number four, the school bully. My favorite of the theories is that there's an intergalactic fruit war going on. And that takes the whole fruit basket exercise to a whole new level. The watermelon is the biggest, baddest alien race out there. Here is Earth, the apple, and everyone else, represented by grapes. The biggest, baddest alien race is really, really hungry, and they're gonna start coming for everybody else in the universe. So none of the other aliens want to make a single sound for fear of being attacked. And strategically, that makes sense. Don't let an enemy know where you are, and you'll survive for many, many more years. But because of that, the little apple that is Earth is also completely unaware of alien life, and therefore blissfully unaware of the intergalactic war of the fruit. We might not ever get attacked, but we might not ever know if there are other beings out there in the universe. Theory number five, the human zoo. Can you just imagine if aliens brought their little alien babies to watch us like monkeys in a zoo? So here is Apple Earth, and here are all the other aliens bringing their little babies to watch us and study us and generally be entertained by our existence. Everything we do is on display and we just don't realize it. That'd be super creepy, but it's totally a possibility. Theory number six, tinfoil hat. On the other hand, maybe there are aliens and they know we're here and we know they're there. Contact has already been made and ET has already phoned home. The thing is, according to the Fermi paradox, not to sound all conspiracy theory, but maybe the government knows all about aliens and they're just not telling us, man. Theory number seven, everything you know is a lie. And just one more of the many other options of alien life and contact, maybe we are the apple, but instead of being delicious and organic, it's digital and tasteless. Maybe everything we think we know about reality is wrong. Maybe we're all living in a simulation that's being run by future human beings or highly advanced aliens. And in this scenario, we're the only life forms being tested. Whatever the theory you subscribe to, it's worth noting that NASA is finding new planets every day. So our potentially delicious banana-shaped aliens might be discovered soon. But until then, we'll just have to theorize.